why are we having a rise in cases? And I'm going to say a little different opinion about that. Well, I obviously everything that everyone else said, but I just want to emphasize, we would not, we, us going through this right now is very political. There are countries who are not going through this right now. There are countries who did not have 300,000 deaths, right? And that's because at the very beginning, they listened to the scientists, literally listened to the scientists. And throughout, like Taiwan, for example, I was reading a woman's blog who went there, and you know, as soon as she arrived in the country, she had to stay locked in this hotel for 2 weeks. She had to be tested every day. She had to give them access to her cell phone so that they could trace her. You know, all of these things that have kept the case rate, they haven't had a case in weeks, not a single case. And they're living their lives just fine. You know, we made some really poor decisions in the beginning. That's why we see rises. We haven't socialized the importance of social distancing, given the fact that we didn't act on testing, given the fact that we didn't believe that the virus was even spreading. You know, we shut down probably a month too late. And by that time it got out of control. And then we also opened up when we had no business opening up, right? We haven't really confined the virus in any way. And now I think I saw a tweet or something on my phone. So go back and check it. Lateral reading for everyone. Everything we say, always go back and find a bunch of things to lateral read on. But one of the things I saw was that that apparently now, you know, the Trump administration in the beginning always wanted herd immunity. And for those of you who are not familiar with herd immunity, is when enough people become immune to the virus by even getting the virus or having a vaccine, that you stop the spread of the virus. And so I personally think the reason why we're seeing the rise in cases, the reason why we've had so many deaths, the reason why all of this is happening is really just poor decisions, not listening to the science, and even the way we socialize it in our mindset around it in the very beginning is really shaped what we're going through right now.
Yeah, to your point, Janina, of course, we had New Zealand, like zero cases of COVID-19. But we also have Germany. Yeah. And I think Germany faced the virus in a united way, a good leadership, and they are still on the rise. So I don't want to diminish the political point, which I think is, it's really important, because the United States, as we see it from the outside, you have all the resources, and honestly, I thought, you know, that you will do a great job. And I mean, not you, but authorities, and that's not the case. But we also have the case of Germany. How would you explain that? And there's like a mix of things.
I mean, I think a large part of it has to go with culture. A large part of it is explained with the culture there being, I think, and I could be wrong, I don't know enough about German culture. I have friends who live there, but the way people are united there is a little bit different. Here you have a lot more different perspectives. We saw with the election, right? We are divided as a country. And I think one of the reasons that we are so divided, one of the reasons why people don't want to believe scientists, is because we've also made science and medicine an elitist thing. And the elitism right now is very, you know, associated with these radical liberals, right? All of that plays a narrative of how people take and think about the virus. I don't even know if I believe that people really think that it's not a thing, or people really think that the vaccines are, I mean, I think that that's true, that a lot of people have fears about that. But I think more of the fear is that, well, why do I want to listen to these elite scientists? And we've kind of our culture has made these things inaccessible, which completely turns off the rest of the population, right? If we continue to make science and medicine, and even when we're talking about the virus, if we continue to make it inaccessible for people who are not scientists, and people who are scientists only look this way and only speak this way and only have these degrees, we are, you know, excluding a lot of information, and there's no trust there. And I think it's shaped by capitalism, and I think it's shaped by a lot of things that now collectively we're seeing a big storm, and it's all coming together. I mean, 2020 has been the perfect storm in so many ways. We have a global pandemic, we have a racial uproar. And because of these things, now we're affecting, you know, parts of our economy. And when you start touching on those things, you bring up a whole bunch of other issues. And so I don't know exactly enough about the culture in Germany, but I know the culture here is shaped largely around these things. And I think it's had a tremendous effect on how we've handled the virus.